Well, hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Long time no see here in my YouTube channel. I have been so busy lately taking care of my my kids, especially my student, because the school year is gonna be done soon. So my daughter has been performing and doing all the school stuff that she's been loving to do, competition, sports, and all those kind of stuff. But I can't really vlog because I have a little one too, so I have to keep my eyes on my little one and to my daughter while she's performing or she's doing all the school stuff that she's been doing. So yeah, and it feels really weird to film again because it's been 2 weeks. That's what happened when I haven't filmed for a longer, and then when I start filming again, it feels so weird. It feels like it's my first time again. Anyway, if you are new to my channel, welcome. It's Nini. Thank you so much for watching, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. And I hope you like this video, which this video is a product review with this makeup look that I am wearing right now. And it is not gonna be like very deep review with this product. I just want to share with you guys my opinion and my experience with the products that I have, which this Wet n Wild, this new palette of them. I don't know if it's a well, it says here new, and I know it's still kind of new. And this Mega Cushion foundation with SPF 15. If you guys are interested, what's my shade? This is a honey beige, a warm. And this one, this palette called Not a Basic Peach. And then for my lips, I am using this Revlon plumping lip cream. And I'm just gonna tell you guys what I think about this. I love this, actually. I really do love it. And it has a cooling sensation on my lips, of course, because this is plumping, which most plumping lip gloss or lipstick has a, at least for me, the plumping lip gloss that I had used always have a cooling sensation. It's like a menthol, so it feels like your lips like look feel plump or bigger, which I don't really need it. It's just I love the I just love the glossy lip gloss or lipstick right now. And I love the shade of this. It looks so natural. I can wear it every day. So in case you guys are interested, this is Spiced Berry. This is 535. And it has a smell. It's a really, really sweet smell. And I'm going to show you guys the consistency of this product. And this is what it looks like, actually. It's a tube like that. And that is the consistency of the product, like that. And let me see. Swatch it over there. There you go. It's really, really nice. I love the shades. I really do. You, if you like lip gloss or even plumping lip gloss, I highly recommend this. It's not a long lasting, of course, because it doesn't say. It's just a like a plumping lip gloss. And if you want like it looks like your lips but better, this shade and this Revlon Kiss Plumping is really, really good if you guys looking for the lip gloss that you wanna wear for the everyday lip gloss. Alright, now let's go with my eyes. And this is what my eyes looks like. It has like a little bit of pop of bright color there, which is not really that bright. So now I'm just gonna tell you guys. Again, this is the palette. So what I think, or my experience, or my opinion about this palette, it's all right, I guess. It's not It's not that good. The darkest shade, it's hard to blend. If you wanna use this, if you have this palette and you haven't used it yet, you have to like start with such a small amount of this and just build it up, because if you start with a lot of product, it's gonna be hard to blend and it's gonna make it look patchy. And this one too, it's kind of hard to blend too. I think the matte, these two is hard to blend. These are too matte, and this one is matte too, this one, but it's not as hard to blend like these two. And I like this transition color, this one. It feels smooth though. It feels really smooth. There you go. But these two is not. Oh, actually it is. This, now that I really swatch it, actually it is smooth. There, and very, very, very pigmented. And let me try this one. It's really smooth, that one too. I don't know why it's hard to blend though. But I use the same technique when I prime my eyelid, the same product that I always use with the other eyeshadow. This is the only two that I had a problem to blend. And this one, I love this one too. They are smooth actually. Yeah, and let me swatch this other one. This one. There. It's not really pigmented, this one. This is what under my eye. So you guys can see it's not the same as that. Look at that. And these two, I'm gonna swatch this. This is very powdery. Look. And I got a lot of, what do you call that? I got a lot of fallout on my face with this one. And it doesn't have much pigmented if I use the brush, so it's better to use the finger. And this one doesn't have much pigmentation, even though I already use my finger of this one on my lids. There you go. And I'm gonna swatch the other one. Let me just wet my finger here. Alright, now I'm gonna swatch this one, which I haven't tried it yet, because this is kind of like my first impression with this. So yeah, and let's see. There, they are smooth actually. I don't know why these two is hard to blend. And then this one, there, I don't know if you guys can see. My light is very bright here, so I can't really see. I hope you guys can see my swatches. And there you go. I think overall it's okay. It's not that bad. The only problem that I have with this palette is these two. But I like the shade of this transition color though, and this one. Overall, the pigmentation is right there, and it's all right. It's not that bad. Yeah, that's it. That's it with my thought about this product. If am I gonna use it again? Maybe not. Maybe if I wanna use this color, this one, because I have other color, this stuff here, I have the same shade in my other palette. So yeah, But yeah, I don't know. I don't think I'm gonna use it again. We'll see. We'll see. All right, now for the last one, this Mega Cushion Foundation. As you guys can see, I have like a dry spot here, a dark scarring, and on my forehead, it covers it, and it looks flawless. It looks like my skin, but better. The only bad thing about this is it made me look so greasy. Yeah, it made me look so greasy. On a camera, it looks nice. It looks like I'm just glowing. But in person, I look like a grease ball. And yeah, because I have an oily skin. So if you have a normal combination skin, like dry, maybe this would work. But for me, I look like a really greasy right now in person. I don't know, in the camera it looks good in camera though, because I look like I'm just ready for it's like a sun-kissed glow in the camera, but in person it's like I look greasy. And it doesn't last that long too. I guess just because I have an oily skin. So yeah, but other than that, I probably will use it again, but not on a really hot day. But I do like it. The coverage, it looks natural. It's buildable. I don't know if it says what it says here. Is it medium coverage? It seems like it's a medium coverage for me, because on just one application, it covers already some part of my imperfection, but not full coverage. But it's built. I think it can build on into the full coverage. So yeah. I think that's it for my review with these three products. Love it, like it, not much. So that's it again, guys. This is just my opinion, my experience, and yeah, I don't know to the other people who have used this if they have the same opinion, but for me, this is all my opinion, so don't get mad at me because I said this thing is not that good, and then for you it is good. Like, it's just me, and with this one too, and this one too. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will see you on my next video. Bye bye.